Hi, my name is Erin Hill, and today I'm going to talk with you about amplicon sequencing in non-invasive samples. I was previously going to discuss QPCR, however, due to COVID, we didn't end up doing this project, and we've moved on to amplicon sequencing instead. So what is an amplicon? This is a short targeted DNA fragment of around 150 base pairs that contains one or more single nucleotide polymorphisms. So this diagram just shows you what a SNP looks like. And it's basically just a base pair change in a sequence. So the shorter fragment lengths make these an ideal alternative to short tandem repeats or microsatellites for non-invasive samples, as these are typically lower quality DNA. We sequence the amplicons via Illumina MiSeq. This requires less DNA than traditional genotyping and can be more cost effective when processing many samples. And it can also be a lot faster than microsatellite genotyping as well. So we've developed these amplicons for SAMBIDIA, and this was done from data already available on GenBank. And we're doing this as part of a larger capture mark recapture project with ARI, and they've collected over 1,000 samples. The preliminary results that I'm going to show you today are based on 38 samples and 71 loci after filtering. And we're comparing the amplicon results to 10 polymorphic microsatellites. And so the same samples were used for both marker types. So the first results are probability of identity, which is the probability that two individuals drawn at random from a population will have the same genotype. So I've minus log 10 transformed the data, so a higher value on the graph equals a lower probability that two individuals will share the same genotype. And you can see with the SNPs shown in red here, because of the sheer number of SNPs that we're able to process using this method, we can be much more confident that the individuals that we do identify downstream aren't due to chance or errors when compared to the microsatellites, which are in the blue down near the bottom. So from our data set of 38 samples, we were able to identify unique individuals. However, the number of unique individuals differed depending on the marker type used. So 17 individuals with the SNPs and 23 with microsatellites. The probability of identity analysis suggests that the SNP results will be more accurate. And we think that we've detected more individuals with the microsatellites due to genotyping errors, which is very common when using both microsatellites and non-invasive samples. And so this just shows that the marker choice for a project can have consequences downstream for management of invasive species. So thank you for listening to my talk. I'd just like to thank the following sample collectors and funding from the Center for Invasive Species Solutions for funding this project. Thank you.